Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hi everyone, I'm Putri Al-Zahra. In this occasion, I would like to present about guess the meaning. But before we jump to the material, let me introduce the members of group 4. They are Akila Khairunisa, Divya Ayu Audini Kuarso, Yogin Fajar Santosa, and of course me. And without any further ado, let me start the presentation. So please pay attention everyone. So have you ever heard to understand full of paragraph? So we can see the common question in this slide. But calm down, we will discuss about the guessing meaning to help you answer the question. Now you can see the diagram on this slide, and I will explain to you what is the diagram's meaning. There are two questions to ask yourself whenever you meet an unfamiliar word. The first question is, do I need to know the meaning of the word? If not, you can keep reading and ignore the word. In order to answer this question, you need to make sure you have a clear purpose in your reading. The second question you need to ask is an approximate meaning enough? If not, you need to look the word up in a dictionary. If the answer to both questions above is no, it means you can guess what the word means, then keep reading. Use the following to help you guess an approximate meaning. First, examine the immediate context of the word. That is, the sentence in which it appears and words which come before and after. Pay particular attention to linking words. Second, examine the wider context of the word. That is, other sentences in the paragraph. Third, look at the structure of the word. That is, prefix, suffix, and root. Next, guessing meaning from context. Guessing from context refers to the ability to infer the meaning of an expression using contextual clues. These clues may be purely linguistic or situational. First, linguistic context. The linguistic environment in which a word is used within a text. Second, situational context. Extra linguistic elements that contribute to the construction of meaning. This may involve background knowledge of the subject. And what this amounts to is that learners should be able to infer the meaning of an unknown word using, first, the meaning of vocabulary items that surround it, second, the way the word is formed, third, background knowledge of the subject and the situation. There are techniques for guessing. First is synonyms and definition. Second, antonym and contrast. Third, cause and effects. And the last is part of speech. And I will explain the example and general knowledge too. Signals of synonyms in the text. Means, called, the verbs, that is, also known as, or is referred to as, sometimes called, is or are known as, by, is mean, similar to, can be defined as, commas, or thesis, and synonyms. And here are the tips. Use these signals to help you identify synonyms or similar process that explain the unknown word. And second, bear in mind that the synonym may appear before or after these signals. And here are the example. The Milky Way is littered with dark obscuring clouds of dust, commonly referred to as coal slakes. And in the sentence, there are obscuring and referred to as coal slakes, and they have the same meanings. Next, antonym and contrast. Antonyms are words that mean the opposite of other words. Antonyms can refer to the opposite idea of an unknown word in the sentence or paragraph. And here are the tips of antonym and contrast. First is select the unknown word. Second, identify is the part of speech. Like, is it a verb, a noun, or an adjective? And third, check if there is a synonym in the sentence that can provide the same meaning of the unknown word. And fourth, determine its positive or negative value. Like, is it a good or a bad thing? And here are the example. The glass might absorb so much acoustic energy that it will shatter. The other glasses remain unaffected. Shatter and unaffected is opposite. Cause and effect. In essence, cause is the thing that makes other things happen. Effect refers to what results. It is the what happened next in the text that results from a preceding cause. To put it concisely, cause is the why something happened and effect is the what happened. For example, he was disrespectful towards other members. That's why he was sent off and penalized. And here are part of speech or immediate context. Consider the following sentence. Although the company's income from sales was higher than expected, its high cost in the form of salaries and the other overheads put it in a disadvantageous position. Imagine the word you want to guess in the sentence is disadvantageous. Okay? It doesn't matter if you already know this word. This is just an example of immediate context. The immediate context of the word tells you the following. First, it is probably an adjective. Why? Because it comes before a noun. I mean, before position. And second, it is probably negative. Why? Because it relates to high costs, which are not usually good for a company, or because the sentence begins with although, a contrast marker. So the idea in the second clause contrasts with the first clause, which is positive. High income is good for a company. So the conclusion is a good guess for the word at this point would be bad. This is probably close enough for you to understand the main idea, and you would be able to keep reading. These advantages have a bad meaning. And here are the examples. Examples can inform the reader about unknown words. They can illustrate the meaning of the word that they refer to. Signals. For instance, such as, including, like, as an example, cases of, instances of, and type of. Example. The Lehigh malware is an example of a computer virus. Next, general knowledge. Sometimes it is necessary to rely on your own experience and background knowledge to figure out the meaning of a word. Read all the words surrounding the unknown term to help you draw conclusions based on the complementary information found in the text. The power of knowledge. Chances are that you may know what word should go on the blank space solely on your knowledge of life experience. See if you can guess which word first fits best with the context and write it down. And the last explanation is using affixes, prefix, suffix, and root. The stem or root in the central part of a word bearing the basic meaning of the word. Affixes attached to the beginning of stems are called prefixes, while suffixes are those attached to the end of the stems. Generally, prefix changes the meaning of a word, while suffix usually changes the part of speech of word. For example, in part of speech, in immediate context, that you have to pretend not to know the meaning of this advantageous. In affixes, you can get the full information by studying the word in this way. First, it is probably an adjective because it ends in -os, which is a common suffix for adjective. And second, it is probably negative because it begins with a negative prefix, -dis. And third, its meaning is probably opposite to the root of the word, advantage. As before, a good guess for the word at this point would be bad. Again, this will be close enough to allow you to understand the main idea and keep reading. Guessing the meaning of new words from affixation, root. Root meaning example. Dig, the meaning is tell or say. An example is predict or a dictation. And grab, the meaning is write. An example, telegraph. And meet or miss, meaning send. An example, transmit or dismiss. Phone, the meaning is sound or voice. And the example is telephone. And port, the meaning is carry. And the example is transport. And script or script, the meaning is write. And the example is describe or inscription. And first or first, the meaning is turn. And the example is invert. Guessing the meaning of new words from affixation, prefix. Prefix meaning example. Un, meaning is not. An example is unhappy. Miss, meaning is wrong. An example is mislead. Anti, and the meaning is against. An example is anti-war. Inter, the meaning is between. An example is international. Pre, meaning is before. And the example is preview. Preview or previously. Re, meaning is back again. An example is repay or repeat. Micro, meaning is small. Example is microscope. And the last is suffixes. Suffix and example. Able or able. The example is movable or considerable. All. The example is visual, digital, and structural. And the example is dependent. Airy, the example is contemporary. Full, the example is powerful, respectful. Each, the example is artistic, graphic, and public. Equal, the example is identical. Easy ways to memorize that affixes are: first, prefix. Prefix is located in the front. And second, suffix is located in the end. And the last is root, is located in the middle. And that's all from our group. Thank you very much for your attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.